What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing SolarWinds Network Performance Monitor, and let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about installing NPM Network Performance Monitor utility or software from SolarWinds, and the way that I did it was the following. Now, I created a Windows Server 2022 for this particular implementation. I mounted the ISO, which is the SolarWinds Orion installer. I right-clicked on the D drive, and I basically said install or run the program from your media. You got this nice little SolarWinds installer. For my demo, for my testing within my environment, I picked a lightweight installation. For the destination folder, you are able to change it. I left it as the default, and I clicked on next. From here, it gives you a nice little list of all the products that you are able to install within this installer. I went all the way to the bottom and I made sure that Network Performance Monitor was checked off, and I clicked on next. From here, it is installing or running hardware check, and I received a lot of warnings. Now, make sure you give this enough memory as well as CPU. I would say give it between 8 to 16 gigs of memory and at least 4 processors or more, because this guy will, even though it gives you warnings and you click next, it looks like it is installing. Eventually, it just gets stuck at a certain point, and it's because you don't have enough memory and CPU power to continue. So make sure you fix those two things. Don't be cheap on this virtual machine. So click on next. Accept the license and terms, and then click next here, and it's going to start installing. From there, you're going to see this nice little dialog box that it is installing IIS8 components, and then it will close up, and you will get this nice little SolarWinds configuration wizard. It will give you a nice completing the Orion configuration wizard. By default, you have launch Orion's web console, so just click finish. Everything will close up and your default browser will open up. Now, the first thing that we need to do is create your password. So make sure you create the password with the requirements that they want. Make sure it's at least 8 characters long, uppercase, lowercase, and it has, you know, a number and all that good stuff, a strong password. And then just click on save and log in. Now, the first thing that you will see is this. So let's click on start. And within start, you got 4 options. I pick IP range. So I clicked on add a range and I added my range that I want this discovery wizard to discover. So once you add your range, click on next, and you have virtualization. And I didn't add any VMware or Hyper-V. So I clicked next here. Any agents, I didn't have any agents installed. So I clicked next here. For SNMP credentials, I left everything as the default, so I clicked on next here. Now for Windows, I do have a couple of Windows machines within my environment, so I clicked on add new credentials. From here, I gave it a name, which would be admin. I gave it my username and a password, and I confirmed the password, and then I clicked on add, and there we go. So I clicked on next here. For the settings to monitor, I enabled the device node polling, so I just hit yes for that. I left everything else as the default and I clicked on next. For discovery setting, I didn't change anything from here. You are able to modify the timeout settings and the WMI retries and all that stuff, but it's up to you. But for my environment, I left everything as is. So I clicked next here. And for the discovering scheduling, I just left it as once. You are able to change the frequency, is up to you, and I clicked on discover. You're going to get this nice little discovering dialog box. If you click on run in background, it will run it behind the scenes. Within this environment, the discovery actually picked up 5 nodes. So once it was done, it gave me this. The next thing was to run the network sonar wizard. This is what I got. This is what it actually picked up, 5 unknown. So I clicked next here. No interfaces were found, so I clicked next here. For the volume types to import, I didn't have any, so I clicked next here. A nice overview of what's going to be imported into NPM, and click on import. Import results. Looks like everything was imported successfully, and you're able to click on finish, and you're done. Now, if you click on my dashboards and click on summary, it gives you what's going on behind the scenes. I already got a couple of errors, which is okay. You're able to click on it and just deep dive into it a little bit more to see what's going on within those servers. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.